Hi, Robert.
Hi, Glei. We are back.
We are back.
You remember the Jaws movie from, I don't know, God, man, maybe that's 30 years ago.
Now I understand why you're a coach.
Yeah, why?
You're not a singer.
I don't understand why I'm a coach. I'm glad you do.
Yeah.
But, yeah, maybe it's all those years of experience. Yeah, that just the more of those years you have of experience doing things the right way, doing things the wrong way, you learn some things along the way.
We had
you can teach those.
Yeah, we had a very interesting week. Mm-hmm. We had a lot of emails asking or requesting for more videos of us.
Right.
From the last time. Very positive response. Mm-hmm. Thank you so much for all the emails and all the likes on Facebook. Mm-hmm.
Because earlier than that, I mean, we did this last video. It was you and me at the park.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
And just, you know, our son is out there having a good time at the park. And we thought, why not just break out the video? Give the folks a chance to meet you and see how awesome you are.
Thank you, Robert.
Because before that, it had been all me in some of these videos talking about topics and, you know, that I and we hoped would be of interest to all of you and you guys could use it. You know, and then we did this video last week, and the mm-hmm. response was overwhelmingly positive. So we thought we'd come back in and start to just mm-hmm. kind of turn on the camera, let it roll,
mm-hmm.
and
mm-hmm.
Go where we will with it.
Yeah, the very common theme from the emails that we got is that a lot of our clients got the importance of taking a break.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and you and I have been doing this for a long, long time. You know, we started working with Trichotillomania in 2006.
Mm-hmm.
But we started our parent company, Bright Life Phobia and Anxiety Relief Center, back in the year 2000. And we saw people for a wide variety of anxiety-related stuff. And I got to say that one of the issues that really were common to all those folks whose anxiety-related problems had become chronic and debilitating was that they were, you know, they're kind of going all the time. An extreme lack of balance, just right there. A lack of balance is an extreme in and of itself. And we've noticed that folks, and we've seen hundreds of people from around the world, maybe thousands now, mm-hmm. from around, all over the world now, since the year 2000, even before then. One of the things we've noticed is that those folks who come in and they're most highly symptomatic, most limited mm-hmm. by their symptoms, it's because they had the least balance in their life. So I thought that was a very important topic that we hit on last week.
Mm-hmm. And by balance, it means?
Well, some of everything. We have a little friend back there.
You know, which brings me to the second common theme of the emails that we received.
What was it? First of all, what was
well,
that?
Well, what was encouraging to people was that we could just flow in the moment.
Sometimes you have no choice.
And that was refreshing.
Right.
You know, like right now, we didn't really decide of what we're going to talk about.
We didn't know the cat was going to sneak up behind
us. Oh, we didn't know that the cat was going to say hello. You know, what was the story about that cat?
So for some time, you know, we had been talking about getting a cat. Nothing really came to fruition out of that. It's been a long time since we've had a pet. But then...
seed was planted,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, the seed had been planted.
And so, that was the intention
of having
a pet in the house.
Right. So we'd been talking about this, and, mm-hmm. you know, we'd visited, you know, whatever, some pet stores and things, you know, but, you know, we... That might be on the weekend. We come back to the week, kind of go back to work and all that. But the intention had certainly been set. We were mm-hmm. thinking about it, but we'd not really, you know,
pet stores and pet shelters,
right?
Rescue cats, yeah. Mm-hmm.
So so there we were one night a few weeks later, and out of nowhere, you know, we're outside getting ready to go someplace, and this little cat shows up, and it's not really a full cat. But, you know, kind of a half kitten, half cat. And it starts being very friendly with us.
Half kitten, half cat.
Well, you know, Kit Kat.
She's a Kit Kat. I like that.
Yeah.
I like that.
Anyway, the cat started coming up very friendly with us. You know, had no collar. We didn't really know where it was from, but it was super, super friendly. I myself mm-hmm. personally had had an experience with this many years earlier, where a cat come to our house. And maybe we, mm-hmm. some of you folks have had the same sort of thing. But basically, the cat found us, adopted us. I just think it was so interesting how, you know, we've been living here for about, here in Lancaster, California, for about 10 years. And now, nothing like this had ever happened before. And there we are, we're talking about it. It's like our thinking moves in that direction. What? All of a sudden, the cat shows up.
She was left behind mm-hmm. by her previous owners.
Right.
And she chose our house.
Somehow.
She was just waiting.
A lot of houses.
She was just waiting outside.
Right.
And when she saw us, like, mm-hmm. she knew.
Yeah.
She knew that this was the home.
Yeah. So that was pretty interesting, and I just thought that was such a wonderful example of this thing where, you know, and I'll just put it like this. Mm-hmm. Sometimes wherever we place the direction of our focus, and we just sort of notice more of that shows up in our life. So, and it's one of the reasons why if you have a problem, you don't want to spend a lot of time focusing on the problem. Why do I have this problem? Why does this always happen to me? Instead, you want to start to think about when you don't have the problem anymore, when it's totally gone and you have something totally different, what would you have then? What would that look like? Because the more you focus on things, and this is, I'm not going to go into it, but they're quantum physical principles that explain all of this, at least in theory. But it's just interesting how that certainly turned out to be the case for us with the cat.
So thoughts are like seeds of intentions.
Mm-hmm.
And the more you focus on it, the more you water it, the more you nurture it, that's what tends to show up.
Yeah. So, I mean, we'll just say it that way. You guys have probably heard this saying, your energy flows where your attention goes. There's a reason why that's a saying. We become what we think about. Another common saying. So it's really all about, in terms of how this applies to you, we want to encourage all of our viewers to be thinking about when you have a problem, it could be hair pulling, could be anything. When you have a problem, what are you going to do with it? Are you going to stay focused on the problem? Are you going to wallow in the mud of the problem? That's easy to do. It's natural. It's normal. Most of us do that. But we encourage you to start directing your focus toward what it is you want, not what it is you don't want. When you, for example, if you don't want to be pulling your hair anymore, we understand all that. What would it be like for you? What would you look like then? How would your world be different? What would you be doing differently? Where would you be going differently? And start to create vivid, sensory-rich imaginations of that instead, and simply disallow focusing on what the problem is and how much you don't like that. You're just going to wallow in the mud. Instead, focus on what it is you want, and you'll actually find yourself feeling better. You'll actually find yourself feeling more excited, more positive about your future.
And what's interesting, when you say, I don't want to pull anymore, it does create a conflict. It does create a struggle to not want to do something.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
So instead of saying, I don't want to pull my hair today, I'm not going to pull my hair today, you know, that creates a tension there because it's something that you have to resist.
Right.
But what if you could say, I'm going to choose to be free today? And think about what you would like to focus on today. I'd like to, you know, it's either I'd like to use my time wisely today. I'd like to smile more today.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
That directs your energy into what you want to create instead.
So that's really, really powerful. So there's one, I think, major message that I think we'd like to impart with all of you today. It's pay attention. It's easy to know what you don't want. We all run into that because we go through this life, we run into problems all the time.
That's
but remember,
right.
For every problem, there's a solution. And the problem isn't the problem. It's what we do with it or don't do with it that becomes the problem. So we encourage you to focus instead on what it is you want. If the problem were resolved easily in the way that would be most ideal for you, what would that look like? What would your life be like? How would you be feeling instead? And create vivid, sensory-rich imaginations of what that'll be like and feel that as you do so. And you'll notice what a difference that makes for you.
So we have to thank the cat after we say and wrap up here, say goodbyes and thank the cat.
Thanks for showing up, Annie. Where's our cat?
Yes,
we're
shaping
the
direction of our videos today.
Anyway, that's a really important thing to be thinking about. So thanks so much for visiting with us here again today. If you're watching this video at our Facebook page, which now has nearly 25,000 followers, and the web address will be there on the screen for you. Please feel free to like us, share us with your friends, maybe people you know who've also been suffering with trichotillomania. If you're watching this at our blog site, feel free to leave a comment. You can do the same thing at Facebook. Any questions you might have. Actually, if you have questions that you'd like us to talk about here on our videos, feel free to visit our website at trich-free.com. You'll see it again here. /QA.html and we'll be happy to look through those and answer as many of those as we possibly can for you.
That's what we would like to be doing for our future videos, is to be answering those questions.
Okay, and our website, www.trich-free.com, and you can always call us at any time of day or night at our 24-hour toll-free voicemail and messaging number, and the number is
866-LIFE-NOW.
866-LIFE-NOW. So feel free to call us, let us know if there's anything we can do for you, and we'll get back to you as soon as we can. Thanks so much for watching. Have a great trick-free week.
Bye.
Bye-bye.